Opened in 2004, the Fraser International History Museum is a three-floor, state-of-the-art museum where history comes alive. Here you can examine historical relics, hear stories from the past, and take an extraordinary journey through 1,000 years of history spanning two continents, combining artifacts from Britain's oldest national museum, the Royal Armouries, with the Fraser Collection. The museum offers its visitors a fascinating educational experience.
I think the fact that we have this extraordinary partnership with the British Royal Armouries, which means that our collections really span in great detail, roughly from the year 1000 all the way up to the turn of the 20th century. That's a chance to see a breadth of history that you don't often get. We have hundreds of objects from the collections of the Royal Armouries. They are English, French, Asian, all sorts of things, and it's just not common to be able to see that kind of depth. And then we have things, of course, from this country too. For example, we have a Bible that belonged to Daniel Boone's family. You can't think of Kentucky and not think of good old Daniel Boone.
There's been a tremendous amount of reciprocal work going on, and I can see that growing in the future. We have exhibits that we put together in the UK that we'll be bringing over here to show at the Fraser, and I'm sure that one day, not too far away, there will be something that starts here that we would love to house back in Leeds in the UK. So it's a flourishing relationship. Everything has grown from strength to strength. There's a huge understanding of culture and the way we do things now and the way things are done here in the United States. It's been great for a hands across the ocean relationship building exercise.
It's a troubling trend. Budget cuts in our nation's educational system driven by a slumping economy. As a result, more and more students run the risk of missing out on exceptional opportunities to learn outside the classroom. In recent years, a growing number of museums have made a conscious effort to step in and fill this void.
There's only so much that can possibly be conveyed by something like a book, a lesson plan, a video. But when you come to, for instance, a history institution and you see a real artifact that somebody used 200 years ago, 1,000 years ago, it gives a student, it gives adults a real sense of people's lives, how we got to where we are, what their struggles were. These objects are very connotative and very exciting to people because it sort of makes your heart leap that you see something that somebody really touched.
Located in downtown Louisville, Kentucky, the Fraser International History Museum gives its visitors the unique opportunity to learn of the total American experience, from our British roots to the present, in an exciting, interactive, insightful, and intelligent way.
The fact that you can, as it were, meet somebody from history, they're very well researched. The person who's doing the reenactment will go through the whole role, but then you can talk to them and find out a bit more about the story. So that, especially for kids, is really a special experience. And then we do have just some extraordinary artifacts that sort of mark a pivotal point, particularly in this country's history. For instance, we have a presentation rifle that was given to George Washington. That's really amazing. And we have Teddy Roosevelt's big stick, which is an extraordinary hunting weapon.
So what we've done is brought over objects from the UK that have been in the Royal Armouries collection for over 500 years, a lot of them. And they are here to help people in the States, we hope, understand more about the American history and how it linked up with the British history. There is a timeline that runs all the way through on the third floor here at the museum to enable mums and dads and teachers to help the young people who inevitably ask the questions, well, what was going on here and why did that happen? We believe that that's a great educational assistance for teachers who come here.
Visitors to the Fraser Museum leave with a broader knowledge of history, a greater respect for the human spirit, and a deeper appreciation of learning.
We began bringing our students to the Fraser Museum about 4 years ago. We feel this is a wonderful classroom extension, especially for fourth grade core content. They love to actually see and work with the educational department here in order to gain a better understanding. When you have manipulatives and the students can actually explore at their own pace and in their own learning style, this allows them to connect the new knowledge to previous knowledge so that they have it with them for the rest of their careers.
Well, a museum brings you not only history, it brings you perspective, and I think that's critically important, but it also brings you a concentration of information that enriches your intellectual, social, economic, and political perspective on things. So I think that's something that you just can't get by just going out all over the world. It's all concentrated right here. So this particular museum has tremendous value, not only to this community, but also it has tremendous value to our nation as a whole. It brings a combination of information that gives a unique perspective on our historical development and those tools that were gained through the centuries that has enabled the United States, for instance, to be a world power. So I think it offers the nation that perspective.
We fervently believe that people need to understand where they came from and what happened in their past, because that helped to make us what we are today. We bring in thousands of school children every year to help with the curriculum. We believe that some of the information that we have here will do exactly the same thing. We're exchanging materials, we're exchanging ideas, and so we just hope it's going to be helpful, not just in the United States, but in the UK as well.
We are the Fraser International History Museum, and we have spent maybe our first 5 years very much focused on that international element. We are expanding to build new galleries that will house local collections. One of our first exhibitions, which will be in May of 2009, is on a place called Fountain Ferry, which was actually an amusement park that opened at the turn of the 20th century and closed in the late 60s. And it has a fascinating history, as many amusement parks do. It actually became a focus for the civil rights movement towards the end of its life. We've looked at local history in terms of some of the problems that were faced and how they were transcended. And I think that makes local history exciting. You will be stunned if you come here by the quality of the collections. If you like objects, if you want to see the real thing, this is the place. Whatever it is, we have the real stuff, and that is what makes this so fascinating, because you can't read about it in that same kind of way. You've got to see it. You've got to be able to go right up to it and press your nose against the glass and have a good look.
For an unforgettable hands-on adventure, make your plans to visit the Fraser International History Museum, where history is happening. For more information, call the number on your screen or visit frasermuseum.org.